Sometimes I feel like we stuck in the matrix. Some people don't know what's real or what's fake. If you like to fall under society's norms, you want to be your true self.
Stay up forward of what we got going on.
The matrix.
That's what's up. Do anybody actually already have a clothing brand? Okay, cool. So this is what I was really wanted to do. I wanted to give y'all information about how to start a clothing brand for people who don't know. And I really want to talk about entrepreneurship because it's very important, especially in the position you are at. What grade is this right now?
It's mixed.
Okay, where's my 12th graders at? So you're about to step into the real world. Do you think about going to college or you want to go to this work right after school? Okay, you're going to do what fits best for you. So I went to college after school. Like after I got out of Older Rights, I went to college. It was the best experience for me because I built a lot of good connections that I still deal with till this day. I got people that I went to college. I graduated in 2018. I first started school, I believe, in 2014. And imagine 7 years later, people that I grew with up there, they're actually still buying my merch. They still support me. They still share my stuff. So it's always good to make those connections now. So when you're actually in the real world, you'll be able to do whatever you want to be. So we won't go around this class too. Like, what are some things y'all inspired to be? Like, where do you want to do for your job, or you want to go to college? And we'll start with you. True.
I really just want to have my own business.
Right, right. Yeah, that's dope, and that's really refreshing to hear, because, like I said, and to each his own, you're going to be able to do whatever you want and wherever God's going to lead you to. But I kind of felt the same way. I didn't know. Like, don't get me wrong. College is a good place to network, and you can set up a foundation so you're able to continue to do whatever you want to do. But I would say, like, for me, just think outside the box. Stay creative. You know what I mean? That's, like I said, that's more source of income that you could be able to get. So that's dope. How about you? No. That makes sense. So I know from, like, you know, we have the traditional way of learning where society trying to push us to, you know, like, we have to get a job, we have to go to school, we have to get married right after school, whatever like that. But it's different now. There's a different time of age. There's more technology out there for us to get the right information that we need. So I really like y'all mindset, and I'm really liking what y'all are saying right now. We're going to go to, like, two more people, and then how about we got these shades on. You can see the body here. How about you in the white hat? What you want to do? Yeah, swear. That's definitely dope. Yeah, picking up trades. Yeah, picking up trades is, like, it's very effective. You know, just having certifications versus degrees, it's a lot cheaper too. So that's something that's, I feel like that's pretty dope as well. And so we ain't asking why we're here. Now, how about you right here, bro? Hold on, let me see. My bad. I got these shades on. I'm sorry. Yeah, you can go. Yeah. We wasn't thinking like this at this age. Now y'all saying some, man, what? Y'all's going to make, y'all, I see future millionaires in here, man. But one thing I have to say, which you have to put it out there first, is something called the laws of attraction. And for people who don't know what that is, who have an idea what that might be? The laws of attraction. You don't know? I'll tell y'all. So basically, the laws of attraction is like when you manifest different things, and it's everything that's in the power of your tongue, it could come true, whether it's something positive or something negative. So would you rather want to talk about something positive, right, versus the negative stuff? So if you're talking about negative things will happen. You talk about positive things will happen. So every day I would say, talk to yourself in the mirror, like, this is what I want to do in my life. Every day. No one can't tell me that I can't do it, because I ain't going to lie. Growing up in the environment that I come from, I mean, it's unheard of. I never was thinking of being a realtor or anything. Even the things that I'm doing right now, I would never thought I would have did it. But it took for me to go through the things that I've been through for me to be where I'm at right now. So I really want to give y'all a hand clap for all the, you know, things y'all got going on. So we got some fun things today. I want to do a giveaway, a free giveaway for my new shade lines called the Scoop Ellos. So I'm going to go around. I'm going to have y'all write y'all names on a piece of paper. And it's like a nice little cardio. So could I have somebody come up and try these on? Who would like to try these on? I'm gonna do two people. I'm gonna do you with the white hat, and her, she had her hand up first. So I'm gonna try these on. So this is something that y'all have a chance to win. And these actually just relaunched. It's called the Scoop Ellos. Say that a little loud for me, Scoop Ellos. Yep. So it's like, so if you know, I don't know if, are y'all familiar with the Cartier, like, buffs? Yeah. So it's very affordable, you know. So I made it like a cheaper style for y'all. It's very, I feel the quality, bro. How you feel? Yeah, very good quality. Man, you gonna have the girls chase you around here, man. You already take them off. How, you wanna try them on? Yeah, try them on. They're for, yeah, you can try them on. Yep. Yeah. I got you. Yeah. I think it's a tiger, I believe. Or maybe a snake. I don't know. They look nice. So that's the relaunch of my shade brand. I started out like a week ago. Well, I released them like a week ago. You want to take a picture? You got some fun? So we're going to talk about like the clothing brand aspect of everything. What you think? I'm going to ask a question. What do you think the things you need to take to actually make a clothing brand? Right. Mm-hmm. Nah, that's true. Confidence for surely. I like them answers. Yep. Game plan. Yep. How you go? Yeah. Yep. Those are very. One more. Yeah. Right. So those are very, very, very good answers, and I appreciate that. And it does take a lot of those things. So I would say one of the main key things as far as like manufacturers and stuff like that, you just got to make sure the manufacturers are good and won't scam you. It's a possibility that they can. They're from overseas. Everything that gets shipped is from overseas. So you always got to make sure. I don't know if y'all be seeing on Instagram, random people might just DM you. You be like, who is this? A lot of scammers out there, so you gotta really make sure you know what you're doing. So, how you feel like? What's some other things like that? There were some good answers. I'm gonna try to get around. I'm trying to get everybody active. What you think you would need to start a clothing brand? Yeah. Swear. Y'all into TikTok? Who got like a lot of followers on TikTok? Okay, y'all. Anybody ever went viral yet? For real? What was like the, what did you cop out at? Like your views? Man, swear. What was the video about? That's crazy. So that's kind of something I need help with. Like, I don't know how to even do TikTok. So what were some things you said that you could have like, tell us a little bit, like a tips to get a TikTok going to get it a little bit more bigger. Yeah. Go ahead. Okay. Oh, I swear that that's definitely dope. So another thing I wanted to do, I wanted to actually break off into doing interviews with, like, I'm gonna do an interview with two students. Who's not scared? What's some of your favorite subjects in school?
My favorite subject is reading, chemistry.
Chemistry. That's what's up. Yeah, I wasn't good in chemistry, so I commend you on that. How about you?
Mine is mostly math.
I wasn't too good at that either. So that's what's up, though. So what would you say some of your struggles in school? Like, what's some things, like, you think about, you know, like, what's some things that you feel like kind of stress you? It's a school period. Okay. Right. The best advice that I got for you for that, because that was what I struggled with too, is finding a balance. Like, find what you need to do and try to decipher the wants and stuff like that. But sometimes when you're needing to do something, you want other things that you really don't need for real. So I will say this, you know, find that balance for real. Take your time when you know you got schoolwork to do, finish that, and everything after that, just, you know, do what you gotta do. How about you? Right. This is a good question I got for a lot of kids. I'm gonna ask in the crowd too. How do y'all deal with stress?
Sleep.
You sleep?
No, I usually play basketball.
You play basketball?
I can't really run. Mm-hmm. I need physical therapy for my knee. I just sleep. Because
okay.
I'm more of a child.
Okay. I'm gonna ask some of the students in the crowd. How do you deal with stress? Yeah. Okay, you just kind of take it on the chin and just keep it going. But always remember to express yourself too. You know, you don't want to keep everything bottled in. It gets hard. Yeah. How about you? Yeah, prayer. Mm-hmm. Y'all got some old souls in here. That's all I'm talking to, like, somebody around my age. I'm gonna let her go first, then you. You listen to music? What's some of your favorite people besides Rod Wave? Like, who do you put on? Who's your go to for stress relief? Rod Wave. How about you? Who? Okay. What's some of you give us some advice as far as your coping skills? What are you doing as far as that? Are you in tune with a studio yet?
No.
We're gonna talk. I'm gonna see what we can do. I mean, I might even try to get you a free hour somewhere. Yeah, I'm gonna keep in contact. Now that's what's up though. Now these are very, very good answers because it gets hard. I'll hold it down real quick for me. Hold it down real quick. So outside of that, so what y'all like to do on y'all free time? Like, what's something?
Basketball.
Basketball.
I haven't been able to really play basketball, but
okay.
I sleep.
You sleep?
But if I didn't have work, it would definitely be chat. And basketball,
since I get out a lot. Okay. How about we gonna go around the class? What y'all like doing on what you like doing on your free time? Okay. That's y'all do a lot of good things. All right. So I'm more in tune with, like, what inspires y'all to keep going? Like, what's some things that inspire y'all that want to just, you know, keep moving forward every day?
My
okay. That's
mine is my younger
brother. Yeah, that's good. Right. Okay. We're gonna go around the room and make sure everybody's active. Who I ain't talked to yet? What keeps you inspired? Yeah. How about you in front of me? Oh, that's good. That's good. So what makes them inspire you so much?
My mom has a doctorate.
Oh, yeah, that's dope, man. That's dope. Y'all are blessed. Y'all are truly blessed for real. And I just want to tell y'all, like, y'all, the power's in your hand. Whatever you really want to do. Like, I'll tell you a little backstory of myself. Like I said, she used to be my teacher. She seen me at probably my lowest points for real. And I knew she always believed in me because, like, man, I was in my environment that I was in wasn't the best, but that ain't dictate how I was going to end up. So I'm telling y'all, like, where it starts at is where you start at right now. Every day you just try to find ways to be better because you can be better. Say I'm going to be good, man. If you say like you feel like you got to mean it, you got to, it should be installed in your soul that you can do whatever y'all want in this world. I swear. So we're definitely, I really appreciate y'all for getting on there. If y'all want to disclose y'all Instagrams or anything like that, if you don't, you don't have to if you want to. But that's just like the page build if you want to, you know, gain your followers.
Look, y'all don't even know my Instagram. Yeah. I'm not going to lie.
Sierra S? Sierra? All right, come on up. You want to scoop Ellos? Like, pop it up for her, man. Pop it up. You must have scooped Ellos, man. So this, you can pick the, I'm about to get these ones. I said. Okay. Let them see it. Turn around. Yeah, she got them Ellos on. She fresh, man. We'll pop
y'all up for real.
Give yourself, and it's nothing good. It's nothing wrong giving yourself a pat on the back sometimes. Make yourself feel good, man. Y'all saying some very good things. So we're gonna get more sad on a mental health note or anything. Like, how was it coming up at home? Like, are you giving like a stable, nice family? Is it pretty good? Right. They're very supportive. Oh, that's good. So how do you handle stress?
I usually just sleep it off.
Okay.
It'll go away eventually.
Right. Did you ever think about any therapy? Ever think about writing notes in your journal or anything like that?
Sometimes I do write, but very rarely now.
Right. Oh, that's good. How about you? What you do? How you deal with stress?
I like dance and sing to get my mind off of it. Mm-hmm.
No, that's what's up, and that's the key word you said is finding peace. Let's say find peace. You can say it a little bit louder. Find peace. Yep. That's one of the key things of life. You know, once you feel happy within yourself, the sky's his limit. What's some things that make y'all happy? Like, what makes y'all happy? Good food. I can attest to that. You can see. How about you? Yeah. I'm gonna get on this side. I've been asked a lot. I'm gonna definitely get over there. What you do? What's some things that make you happy? Mm-hmm. Yeah, there's a lot of people like music. You can't go wrong with it. How about you? Money, for surely. Swear. Uh-huh. How about, I'm gonna ask one of y'all guys. What y'all do? What's some things that make y'all happy? Okay. Yeah, that's cool. That's definitely dope. Those are very good coping mechanisms. That's what I do too. I like to listen to music sometimes when I stress. I go for walks. Y'all in the nature?
Yeah.
Yeah, swear. There's a lot of good walk parts. I like to play basketball sometimes to get off the stress and stuff like that. Cause I'm not gonna lie, like school does make you stress, man. A lot of work. What's something? What was like your best assignment that you feel like you did this year that you kind of like? Okay. You said a story? Okay. Okay. How about you?
I don't even know. I haven't done a lot of projects this year.
Right. Work. Right. Who could see themselves being a teacher?
No, never.
Right. So are you guys into fashion? Do y'all like clothes and stuff like that? Yeah. What's some of y'all like your shoes you got on? What's some of y'all favorite brands? Okay. How about you? Okay. Oh, that's what's up. Let's give them a hand clap, bro. Y'all had some very good feedback. All right, so where do y'all see yourself outside of school? Like, what you think y'all gonna do?
You know, I wanna go into like a school that's really good, like nursing, and has a program for that. But mm-hmm. I haven't found the right one yet. But I'm looking, you know. But probably something.
Okay. How about you? Entrepreneur, okay, and then let's talk about it. What exactly you wanted to do? Yeah. Okay. All right, by a show of hands, I'm going to say it one more time. Like, who want to have a clothing brand in here? All right, cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to write down a listing on how to, like, actually start it, you know? So you got to find manufacturers. You got to find different ways to market. Everybody got their hand. Raise your hand one more time. I'm 100% free. I'm going to let y'all enter my consulting program, basically where I will help you know about the manufacturers, anything y'all would like to know. If y'all need any type of information, just write me down your Instagram or whatever way to get in contact with you, and we'll be able to help y'all. Yeah. That was what a student I had met. So, yeah, man, I really appreciate y'all, you know, coming through and showing some love. We're going to take some pictures. I'm feeling good. I might raffle off a shirt for one of y'all. So somebody else come up here.
Jayana. Okay, I got it right.
Hey. Jayana, tell me. No. Huh? There's two Jayanas? All right. Well, let me know what size you wear. Medium. I think I got a medium. Can you take a small feel if there ain't no medium? Are you able to take a small feel?
Yeah.
No problem. Right, here you go. So who's all able to take a picture and video and stuff like that? Everybody for the most part? All right, cool.
See, I don't know if y'all remember the Boondocks. Y'all ever seen that show before? Yeah. So I kind of wanted the same type of concept. It's like a urban-ass type of cartoon. So I literally was just in my college class. And one of my, it was like my graphic design class. And I met a girl in there. And she said that she'll kind of smooth the lines out for my logo. So I was just, you know, bored. I like to doodle. I can draw as well. And I just came up with this. And I'm trying to make sure that it's seen everywhere. So what I want to say, if y'all are showing y'all clothing brand, when it comes to logos, make sure that you have vibrant colors. When you look at McDonald's, you see red, you see yellow and stuff like that. And it kind of makes you hungry, right? When y'all see like yellow and red, do y'all get kind of hungry when y'all see that? For real, I do. I see McDonald's, I be trying to eat, you know what I mean? What's up, bro? How you doing? So, yeah, so that's pretty much where I came with the Scoop TV logo. Any more questions? No, there's no back on this hoodie. Huh? Yeah, you're probably going to crowd around. Hold on, let me take these.
Hold on. You sick. Oh, no, here we go.
Who has a question? All right, let me know. So basically, I'm gonna be 100% honest, cause it kind of grew over time. So basically, when I first started, you know, I had to learn about networking. Networking is the main thing, making sure you're out there and making your face publicly known and stuff like that. And if you're talking about for the clothing brand, right? All right, yeah. So when I got in the clothing brand, see who your audience is. You got to actually see, you got to go around, you got to, like I said, network and see who your actual audience is and who you'll be selling to. Sorry about that. But yeah, that's pretty much the main steps. Find manufacturers. That's something I will write down too. We want to search for manufacturers. You can find your manufacturers on Instagram. Just make sure that you got other people that actually worked with them before so you don't get scammed, like I said. Logo, definitely find a very good graphic designer. Yeah, they should be able to fix it for you. So if you have, and I will always say write on print paper, don't write on line paper. If you're making your own logos, send that over. They'll be able to scan it and they'll be able to smooth the lines out for you so you can actually make an actual logo. So yeah. Yeah, definitely a good graphic designer. Pop-up shops are very effective. Once you actually get the merch, that's how you make the money. You know, keep your things at a reasonable price until you actually grow a little bit more, then you can elevate your price. This is some very, very good, very, very good knowledge because this is how you really get the money. What really put me up to where I needed to be was pop-up shops. I was going to different cities for pop-up shops. I was going to college campuses for pop-up shops just to get my brand out of my face out there. Networking is key to anything in life. Sometimes networking can help you more than an actual degree. And that's not, I'm not putting nothing in past people that want to go to college. Definitely go to college. But while you're in college, make sure you set your foundation. So when you're out of college, you have something to look towards. So that's pretty much my best advice for y'all. Any other questions? Go ahead. Say that again. Well, from clothes. When at my peak, I would say, I'll say the exact number, but at my peak, when I first started my zip-up hoodies, I was making anywhere from $3,000 to $4,000 a month, not including the videos that I was doing too, like my media stuff. So yeah, so you could add that up and see what that is. But if you do it, it's consistent, you can make a lot of money from clothes for real. So check that out. When y'all get a chance, research how much you make starting a clothing brand. There's people that make millions. Right. So what's now that's very understanding. That was something I struggled with too when I was growing up and going to school, was actually getting there. But you got here, so that's you're doing for the step one, you know. So what's some of y'all favorite subjects?
My favorite subjects are reading and history.
Right, and why would you say that?
I feel like those are my strongest suits. I don't really like math and science, but I try my best.
Right. How about you, bro?
Honestly, the same thing she said.
Yes. That's crazy. Yeah, I definitely did like reading classes, writing papers and stuff like that. That was my strong suit. So y'all into music? Yeah. So who's some of y'all favorite artists?
I really like 90s R&B.
Right, for real, yeah. Right, man.
I like old music. Like I'm not against like the music now,
right?
But, like I would prefer like 90s R&B and like.
Okay. Yeah, how about you?
Right now, I'm listening to a lot of ASAP Rocky. He's just been fun.
Yeah, he be going crazy. I'm gonna even ask some questions in the crowd too. So what's some of y'all favorite artists? Go ahead. Rod Wave, yeah, he got a nice wave. How about you? Okay. Some good choices. How about you? You like Drake? Right, right. So I want to ask this question. Hold it down for me. Where do you see yourself in the next, we're going to say the 2 years?
In 2 years, I see myself completing school and hopefully getting into a good college.
Right, right.
Because I want to be a therapist and also probably a teacher. I feel like that's what we need more of, especially right. Black teachers.
Mm-hmm.
So I see myself really like working towards that goal to get into a good college and keep myself consistent so I can actually,
And you already got the head straight. You got an old soul, for real. You get that a lot?
Yeah.
Oh, that's what's up. How about you, bro?
Probably in the union.
Yeah.
Like, somewhere where I have free time. Like, right. Do other stuff that can get me, like, further in life. And that's, like, good money. Just the union is definitely good money.
Right, right. Oh, that's definitely dope. So I want the class to do this for me. We're going to eliminate the word I might, I don't know, and say I will. All right? So one on the count of three, we're gonna say I will. 1, 2, 3.
I will.
And reason why I say that, because you're already kind of like coming up with the idea that you might not do that. If you really want something in life, you gotta say I will do it. You gotta tell yourself that every day, like I was saying before, is everything's in the power of the tongue. So whatever you're saying that it might happen, whether it's good or bad. So that's definitely dope. I appreciate that.
Please don't forget about me. But them times I had to show you to act like you didn't hear about it. All them times I hit your phone and you told me you would think about it. And I just thought about it. Used to ask, can you please hear my shit? You wouldn't do it. Told you every day I was gonna blow. I had to prove it. Gave you chance after chance and you always said I'm blew it. I know it. My heart said you wouldn't even do it. Damn.